The first witness called to the stand had the entire courtroom in tears. Channel 4 Action News Westmoreland County Bureau Chief Jennifer Mealy is live. Jen.
Well, Wendy, I can tell you jurors were showed pictures today of Jennifer Daugherty's body, and they're so graphic we can't show you them on TV. But I can tell you the entire Daugherty family was in tears. Some jurors were sobbing, even the suspect herself crying. So the judge had to call for a break in testimony. It was a cold, snowy February morning in 2010. School was canceled and the roads were so bad, a truck driver was forced to park his truck in the lot outside Greensburg Salem Middle School. When he went to move it, he discovered a trash can shoved underneath it and, to his horror, a body inside. Moments before, Rebecca Clark's dad was driving her to work.
Something was suspicious about what we saw, yes.
Why?
Two people dragging a garbage can across the road seems a little odd.
It wasn't until they saw the news later that day about a body in a garbage can that a chill went up their spines.
She told me about it that day, and I came to the police station here and started telling the story.
I immediately felt sick. I felt horrible. I knew that we had been a witness to it and what had happened, and I just felt very bad for the family and friends, and if we could have helped in any way, I wanted to.
So she became the first witness called to the stand to testify against Angela Marinucci, a woman who police say wanted Jennifer Daugherty dead because she was jealous of her relationship with Ricky Smyrns. She and several others were staying at Smyrns' apartment in Greensburg, and when Daugherty arrived, the gang up on her began. Police say Marinucci, Smyrns, and the others tortured Daugherty for 2 days before stabbing her to death. Daugherty's family was sobbing as prosecutors showed the jury pictures of her bruised and battered body. Clutching a bath towel, Christmas lights tied around her neck, red nail polish painted on her face, her head shaved, and 7 stab wounds to her chest.